A warm welcome to this afternoon session. I am personally very happy with the involvement of all the participants in the morning session. There were very enthusiastic presentations made by all the groups which were making an exhibitive presentation in the morning. And what is equally important is that the people who were going around to examine the presentations were doing so with great enthusiasm. I would strongly recommend that you should preserve these exhibits which you have made for the future. You know, you can, many people I saw have made some very beautiful posters and presentation material. You must preserve it, it will be useful in future, it should be very useful. It will be useful for you to, you know, present it at other conferences or exhibitions as well. Now, in the afternoon session, we again continue with the same pattern as the morning, but I would also like to take this opportunity to welcome a guest which we have from the Institute. I have requested him to serve as a guest of honor for this event under the TechWhip program, MHRD TechWhip Kite. We have Professor Chandrasekhar. You come, we are from the Department of Earth Sciences. Professor Chandrasekhar is in the Department of Earth Sciences and he's been helpful on many occasions in the organization of events related to TechWhip Kite, MHRD TechWhip Kite. And especially Professor Chandrasekhar has, his area of research also relates to wavelets in the domain of geophysical signal processing and geophysical data processing. And in fact, he's done a lot of work in that direction. Some of his PhD students also are doing work in that direction. In fact, he's also contemplating, we are guiding some work together. Now, I have great pleasure in welcoming him in the afternoon session as a guest of honor. And towards the end, I mean, he'll also probably make, I'll request him to say a few words about what he thought about the morning presentations that he went around to see. Now, a few instructions that I wanted to give you for the afternoon session. Of course, you know, you're quite familiar with the process that we are going to follow now. We follow almost an identical process for the afternoon. But a few things should be kept in mind. One is that you must try and make use of all the rooms as much as you can. In fact, we had a contrary situation in the morning. This room was very sparsely occupied for some time. And that is not really necessary. This room is the biggest among the rooms that we have. So you can leave about one bench between groups, but otherwise you can occupy this room. And then in the first floor classrooms, don't put all the presentations on the blackboard. You can use the benches also to make a presentation, right? So please spread the presentations as much as you can. The reason is because people should have space to go around and see the presentations and talk to you. It's very important that they talk to you and discuss. Also, this is particularly true for the IIT Bombay students. I expect you to actually look at 15 presentations. And, you know, I'm not sure how many you've looked at, but that's where your target should be, right? So at least in the afternoon, try and meet that target. Now, without further ado, I will just request Professor Chandrasekhar to say a few words about this event. In fact, Professor Chandrasekhar had kindly graced the previous event on April 13th, 2014. You know, and he has an experience of that event and he may say a few words about, you know, how he thought that event was and how he expected it to evolve. And he was also involved in organizing that. And we would now look forward to a few words from Professor Chandrasekhar.
Good afternoon, and first of all, I would like to thank Professor Gadre for inviting me for this workshop, MHRD TechWhip workshop on wavelets. Last year there were many interesting presentations, as I was also involved in that, be it on denoising or fingerprint scanning and so many other aspects. Actually, I forgot, you know, there were so many other interesting aspects. And this year, I was very delighted to see similar topics in the morning, and also the face recognition techniques, and more important thing I found was that contourlet transforms, and then there was one more on Hough transform, and then interesting thing was on 1D wavelet prediction using, vector machine. So these are very interesting thing. I will discuss about it later, okay. And then for this workshop, Of course, I came late in the morning. But anyway, one interesting thing what I have observed here is, compared to last year, this time the number of participants is almost doubled actually. This is very good sign for people who are working in wavelets, and then I think it will be more in the coming years also. Okay, so thanks and all the efforts, and then sincere efforts and acknowledgements must go to Professor Gadre, who has been keen in organizing all these things. And not only that, I also came to know that all these, whatever you people are presenting, are preserved in Professor Gadre's wavelet courses in IIT's Moodle website, so that your future or your junior students, whosoever will be coming in the next year and all, they will have a look at your work, and then they will improve upon on all these aspects. So this is a very interesting thing. That you people will be displaying in this afternoon session, particularly I was told that wavelets solution of differential equations, or even ordinary or partial differential equations using wavelet schemes and all, I would like to see those issues. Okay, and also some other things which I do not know yet. Okay, so I think I will have a good time learning from you people. Okay, and then let us see how it will turn out to be in the end. Thank you very much.
Now, as in the morning session, we'll have a quick presentation of a minute each from the groups, followed by, of course, setting up your presentations that we did in the morning. It's very important for the IIT Bombay students to ensure that you are evaluated by some of the teaching associates, because they are going to evaluate you finally in your application assignment. But all the IIT Bombay students must also make sure that you have seen at least 15 presentations, 1-5. In the session in which you are going around, and try and talk to them to find out. Doesn't matter, it's a bit of time pressure, I know, but that's how it should be. There should be a time pressure, because there must be so much to learn, and you shouldn't feel that lack of something to learn from this whole experience. And now for the people from the other institutes, I also want to emphasize to you that I know you might be overwhelmed by the number of presentations, but again, you must try and look at at least 15, and make notes on them. Right, and we expect you to turn in your report before you depart. Some of the people from outside might need to leave by train. How many of you need to leave by about 4 o'clock by train? Very few people need, I think. Yeah. In any case, we will conclude this session by about 4:45. Right, the second session. We'll follow the same process for high tea. We'll be serving the high tea around 4:45 or so. So you can go in smaller groups, have high tea, and continue your discussion, and then reassemble here. And finally, here we will have a concluding session for about 15 to 20 minutes in the end. Is that right? So around 5 o'clock. So what you should do is yourself, you should modulate your going around the exhibition, and you can go for high tea after 4:30 in smaller groups. And then after you have seen the presentations, come and reassemble here around 5 o'clock. Is that right? So I don't need to keep telling you go for high tea, go this. So at around 4:30, you can do it in smaller groups, don't go all at once. And the IIT students should make it a conscious effort to take along some students from other institutes, get to know them, and take them along for high tea. I have again given instructions to the catering staff not to serve the IIT students high tea until they bring people from other institutes with them. Is that right? And so the other people from other institutes also try to take along people from IIT, otherwise they won't get food. So, it's good that you should catch them and take them along. Very good. Now, again, as in the morning, please quickly form a queue of groups, first from the IIT, starting with group 2, one after the other, and systematically come and make a presentation in about 1 minute each. And then similarly, people from other institutes who are making a presentation are also requested to be ready after the IIT Bombay. Let's start with group 2.
Good afternoon. My name is Akshat. This is Ashray. And this is Tarun. We're all fourth year undergraduates. And our project is based on iris recognition. So iris is as a form of biometric system act as a far more convenient, stable and unique feature of identification compared to fingerprints or retinas. So we implement our program by first segmenting an iris image, and using 2D Gabor wavelets, we decompose the spatial information and encode it into a feature vector, which we refer to as the iris code. And then by employing a certain distance metric, we ascertain the dissimilarity between two iris images, and we can recognize an individual's own iris with respect to others. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Saksham. This is Vivek and Nirmal. So our topic is signal compression and denoising using wavelet techniques. So you may have come across many data signals in the morning session. So eventually they have to be transmitted or stored. So in do it effectively, we need to compress it. So what we have tried here is that we have tried to find a wavelet which is best for a given data signal for giving a better compression ratio. We have compared different wavelets for compression ratios for different level of decompositions, and we'll demonstrate it on ECG signals and audio signals. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Hemant Kumar. This is Tushar and DV Yadav. We are M.Tech first years. Our project is on image fusion. Image fusion is generally used in remote sensing, where multiple sensor images have to be fused together to form a one final detailed image. So when we come into the spatial domain like images, first generation wavelets are not that much useful here. So we go on to second generation wavelets, and the particular second generation wavelets we have used are edge avoiding wavelets proposed by Rannan and Feather. It's actually a patented formula by Rannan, which is currently used in Photoshop, called as feature protect details. This feature particularly becomes useful when you are making a smoothing over a small area, where you also have to protect your detail. So this is in Photoshop called protect detail feature. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Sagar, and this is my project mate Rajesh Kumar Mishra and Karthik. We are all M.Tech first year students. Our project is on application of wavelets on 2D gel electrophoresis images. Why I'm stressing electrophoresis is that people keep asking what is your project name. So it's electrophoresis, which deals with proteomics. So study on proteomics. We have these protein spots. So major challenge on this images is the denoising technique. So there will be vertical streaks, a non-linear background. So we have to denoise those images. That's a major challenge. So we operate on 2D gel images. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon. Myself Asim Singh Rawat, he is my partner Mr. Sandeep and Pooja. We are working on application of wavelet, continuous wavelet transform for vibration calculation. In this project, we have taken some simulated vibration signals and calculated the vibration frequency corresponding to those signals, which are simulating the actual signal. And then we have taken an actual vibration signal from an interferometric setup, which is a FM modulated nature of signal. We have found out the actual frequencies and demodulate on the modulating signal. All are welcome to see our presentation. Thank you.
Very good afternoon to one and all. I'm Febin. These are my project mates Prachir and Saket. I'm sure you'd all love to just issue commands to your computer, your car, or your laptop. Save this file, turn left, close the doors. And that's what speech recognition is about. But before you can have speech recognition, you need to have speech segmentation, which in itself is a very complicated part. You need to be able to identify the individual lexical unit of speech. That's what we call a phoneme. Now, many current existing methods use what we call constant timed decomposition. And these cause certain issues with boundary detection. And moreover, they're perceptually unnatural to how the human mind detects phonemes. So what we've tried to do some research about is using wavelets to do this same speech segmentation and detect phoneme boundaries. So you're all welcome to come and meet us at group number 12, speech segmentation using wavelets. Thank you.
Hello everyone.
My name is Garvit and he is Abhishek. Our project is on image zooming using wavelets. So there have been various methods like image linear interpolation or image pixel replication. But these methods have their own shortcomings. So to avoid these shortcomings, we are using wavelets to zoom the image.
So I am Devendra, this is Anand and Shubham, we are fourth year undergrad. So we are working on texture image retrieval. So texture images have like unique variants of strength across the edges and have periodicity.
So our application theme is a multi-scale edge detection using dynamic wavelet transform. At smaller scale, you can get finer details from finer image details, including noise. But at large, if you use large scale, you can get coarser image details, but these edges are not so well localized. So in this multi-scale technique, we are trying to address both this issue. That means we are trying to minimize the noise appearing in the edge image, and also try to get well localized edges. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Sanjay Azad and he is Vaibha Mahatme, and our project is application of wavelets in OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. It is an spectrally efficient technique of parallel data transmission, where narrow bands are transmitted in a wide band channel and narrow bands are orthogonal as well as overlapping. So it is generally implemented using fast Fourier transform, but that has a problem that side lobes are very high. So there is a power loss. So implementing it using a wavelet transform gives a better side lobe compression, and as a result we gain spectral efficiency as well as power efficiency. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Madhulika and this is Pranav. Both of us are in fourth year electrical engineering. Our topic is denoising ECG signal using DWT and thresholding. In this we have discussed pretty much the underlying procedure of denoising, which is commonly applicable, and we have shown particular waveforms and performance using different wavelets for the case of ECG signals. Thank you.
Hello. Hi, my name is Ankur. I'm a fourth year dual degree student of IIT Bombay. This is Krishnakant and this is Akshay. They are also fourth year dual degree students. So our project is based on image steganography. Basically, steganography is hiding the existence of data while sending it. So we are sending an audio signal and within it we are sending some data. So at the output, at the received output, you will be able to hear the audio signal, but you will not be aware of the existence of any encrypted data in it. So if you want to listen to some good songs and understand steganography, then please come and visit our stall. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Gaurav. I'm a fourth year BTech student.
I'm Arjun, fourth year dual degree student. And
I'm Ajinkya, fourth year dual degree student.
So our project is the segmentation of speech. Speech, as you know, is a fundamental mode of human communication, and it is very important that we try to make sense of it. And we try to tell the computer how to make sense of it too. Now, the standard techniques of speech segmentation involve what is called the short time Fourier transform. This does not only provide impose constraints in terms of the resolution of the frequency, but also is an extremely computationally inefficient thing. As in, you compute so much information and you end up throwing most of it while you do the processing. The wavelet transform, however, computes exactly what is needed and uses the maximum computation efficiency to achieve the same. And therefore, we have computed 6 levels of wavelet coefficients, which extract information across different frequency bands. Changes in these frequency bands are measured and are used to segment the speech. That's it. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Palaj and this is Tushar. And our topic is using wavelets for edge detection in image processing. So you must have seen a lot of face recognition and iris recognition projects in the first session. So a major component of these processes is detecting features from these faces and images. So our project deals with ways to extract these features from the images. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Chandrakant, and this is Arun Satish and my
colleague. We are presenting on SAR signal processing using fractional Fourier transform.
In a typical SAR processing, when the antenna is mounted on a moving platform and moving in the at an altitude, because of the finite beamwidth of the antenna, the target is seen from a finite distance. I mean, at distance, it is seen by multiple beams at different distances, and that single point target is spread out because of the each. It is interpreted as at different ranges because of the different beamwidths and different locations of the flight motion. So we'll be trying to compress that spread out target using fractional Fourier transform. Ideally, nowadays typically it is 50 is used for these kind of things. But since the transmission signal for a radar is a chirp signal, and a chirp signal can be more compactly represented in fractional Fourier transform, we are using FRFT. And for further details, please come to our presentation. Thank you.
Hello everyone, myself Suryakant Gautam. I am working in the sensor abrupt fault detection using wavelets. Abrupt fault in the sense bias, spike fault, stuck fault, cyclic and erratic fault, to minimize the machine failure as well as to prevent the maintenance of the process.
Good afternoon everyone, my name is Shivam Bharadwaj, and he is my friend and colleague Mr. Ramesh R. The topic of my presentation or project is use of HAR wavelets in solving the linear differential equation that arise in the context of linear time invariant systems, and the extending this idea for solving the optimal control problem. So in this in my presentation, I have we have used a HAR transform matrix and shown that this idea is somewhat related to multi resolution analysis, and we will see that how the multi resolution analysis technique is helpful in solving the differential equation computationally, and we will see some of its disadvantages also. So since it is all about differential equations which arises in many applications, so most of you are welcome for our presentation. Thank you.
Good afternoon all, I am Sakshi and she is Maitri. We are MTech second year students. Our project is image denoising using wavelets. Since the digital images are usually corrupted with noise due to transmission or storage, therefore what we are trying to do, we are trying to retrieve the original image from the noisy version using different thresholding techniques, and the results of various techniques are then compared using a parameter that is signal to noise ratio. Thank you.
So I believe that, that's a different institute. I believe that is all the IIT groups. Now we'll have the groups of other institutes also come. So could you now come one by one?
Hello everyone, I'm Yogesh Rao from VJTI. Basically we are working on optical coherence tomography imaging techniques, and here we would like to present applications of wavelet one stage or two stage in OCT images for basically noise removal and then enhancement of those images. And also we have tried to compare this technique, the proposed idea, with the then existing GHE algorithms and all other techniques. Thank you.
Good afternoon all, my name is Shivraj Rathod. I am MTech second year electronic student of VJTI Mumbai. My topic for presentation is antenna based signal processing technique for radar systems. Right now we are using radar system with parabolic antenna, so we have used auxiliary antenna on the same parabolic reflector antenna to detect the enemy of the fighter planes. So we have used fast Fourier transform along with direction of arrival algorithm to detect the enemy. So hope you will enjoy it. Thank you.
Good afternoon everyone, myself Samarth from SGGS Institute. The topic of my research is visibility restoration of underwater optical images. Now this can be done using two approaches, single image or multiple image. Here I am using single images. I am going to use the different algorithms such as dark channel prior algorithm. In this there is one transmission estimation module which makes use of Retinex algorithm, which is applied on the luminance component of YCBCR. Now to extract this information, I'm going to use a wavelet in my application. Thank you.
Good afternoon everyone, I'm Ravi Kambe, research scholar from HGGS Nanded. My topic is
content based retinal image retrieval system, which aims to propose a diagnosis help system to retrieve images of diabetic retinopathy at the same disease severity level using wavelet transform. Okay, thank you.
Any other groups that are going to make a presentation in this session? Very good. So we have a very interesting set of presentations coming up here too. Now we'll try and we've had an experience in the morning how to go around and look at the presentations and all how to make a presentation. This time we'll try to be more efficient. We also have a little less time. It's about 3:05 now. So we should complete, you know, high tea will be served after 4:40 or so. So, you know, you can plan to in fact combine going around and then having high tea after 4:30, and then after we are done at looking at most all the presentations, then you should all assemble here around 5 o'clock, right? So we have about 2 hours, 5 to 5:05 or so. You should come back here and have high tea before you come, right? Go in small groups, that's desirable. And again, make sure that you see at least 15 presentations, yes, and spread yourselves nicely, use all the rooms. Please enjoy the session. We'll reassemble here at 5 o'clock. IIT students should make sure that the TAs see your presentation. I believe you've already gone around several presentations and you've learnt a lot from what you saw in what people were presenting. Before we conclude, I would like to say a few words about the intent of this whole workshop and what was the purpose. Of course, I said a little bit in the morning, but I think you will understand it better now. This is particularly true, in fact, for the outside participants, but I would say it's equally true for the IIT Bombay students. It is often, as I said, the case that we don't understand how many things there are to be known or learnt in a subject, and however much we might learn in the classroom or we might learn on our own, it's always a limitation that we experience. You know, there's beyond a point, there's just so much we can learn on our own. Learning is a combination of both competition and cooperation. A certain amount of competition is needed in the process of learning because one needs to find one's own standards of excellence. So if there's no competition, there's no desire to rise to a certain level of excellence. In contrast, if it is only competition that promotes learning, there is a tendency again for learning to get limited after some time, because you only learn and in fact you also refuse to learn from others implicitly or explicitly. You know, in competition, the tendency is after a point not to want to share knowledge. Up to a point one might want to share, because there is a certain basic level of excellence which one wants to achieve. But beyond that point, on account of competition, learning starts getting channeled into narrow walls, into narrow boundaries. That is actually against a genuine process of learning in depth. At that stage, cooperation becomes important. And what we saw today was an exercise in cooperative learning. I think you will now appreciate and agree after this whole workshop that cooperative learning takes you much farther than competitive learning after a point. There is a certain amount of skill that you need to acquire, and beyond that, cooperative learning is important. In cooperative learning, what is important is that everybody who is participating in the process of learning needs to be serious about learning, needs to be conscientious about doing his or her duty in that process of learning properly, and then everybody benefits. Where cooperative exercises fail, for example in high school or in college, is where people do not do their part of the duty of cooperative learning. So when I copy assignments from others, I am not doing my part of the learning process and therefore I don't benefit from it. But if all of us are doing assignments, and if we are doing different assignments, and if we learn from one another's assignments, then the overall exercise of learning is much more successful. So this is where competitive learning versus cooperative learning has a place, you know, and a meaning in education. And the whole aim of this exercise in this workshop was to illustrate as a pedagogical strategy, as a pedagogical process or as a pedagogical approach, the whole issue of competitive and cooperative learning, right? So, this is particularly true for the faculty and students who have come from other institutes, but as I said, it applies equally well to students of IIT Bombay. Now, that was a little bit about what this TechWhip workshop was for, and this should be on record, that is why I mentioned it. We would now like to conclude this workshop by, of course, first appreciating all of you. So, let us give ourselves a very big hand for an excellent exhibition come presentation. I think it was an excellent exhibition. In fact, as Chandrasekhar shares with me, I am going to request him to say a few words, that he is also very happy with what was done. But before Professor before we speak and conclude, we would like to hear from at least one representative of all the other external institutes. And you know, I take that opportunity also to hand over the certificates. We have certificates of participation for people from the other institutes. And I would first request, you know, VJTI has the largest participation here, nearly 50 people. I think we should give VJTI a big hand. They were able to garner 50 people to come and. So, may I request some representatives of VJTI to come and tell us how the experience, what their experience was in this workshop. Maybe Professor Rahul Ingre himself can come. Perhaps you can come here because it will be easier to, yeah.
Hello. Myself, Rahul Ingre, I am working as a faculty member in the Electrical Engineering Department of VJTI. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Vikram Gadre and their entire CDIT team for organizing such a knowledgeable workshop for all the for all of us. Secondly, I would like to thank the MHRD, that is Ministry of Human Resource and Development, NPIU, National Project Implementation Unit, SPFU, State Felicitation, Project Felicitation Unit, Maharashtra Government, because they provided us the platform in the form of KITE, that is Knowledge Incubation under TechWhip. So, I thank all of them for providing us to interact with the world of the knowledge which is there in the IIT. And because of them only, today we were able to interact with the IIT students and as well as the professors of the IIT. Last but not least, I would like to thank my Honorable Director, Dr. O.G. Kakde, my respected Head of Department, Dr. R.N. Awale, because of whom we are able to come to IIT. And it will be injustice if I will not take the name of the IIT students, because their presentation was such a wonderful that today we came to know that there are lot of application in the Violet, and we came to know just because of them. So, I thank all the VJTI students as well as the IIT students for presenting such nice presentations. So, thanks so much, sir.
So, we won't give out individual certificates, I think that's, you know, it takes too much of time, but we'll give it institution by institution. Now, let me request the Sardar Patel College of Engineering, Mumbai. I suppose we have a few representatives from there. So, SPCOE, any representatives from there? Yeah. So, you can introduce yourself and then.
Good evening, everybody. I'm V.S. Dake. I'm working as an assistant professor in the Sardar Patel College of Engineering in the electrical department. Firstly, I would like to thank Professor Gadre sir and all his team member because of to organizing such excellent event, as well as I would like to thank all the organization to participate in that event, because it is nice, wonderful event. Actually, this was my first experience, so I really get a good knowledge from that event. The actual application of the wavelet waveform theory in the electrical area as well as in other areas. So it's a wonderful event. Thank you very much.
Very good. So, Professor Daki, may I request you to accept these certificates on behalf of all of us and then arrange to distribute them to your participants. Thank you. So, now I believe we have a few participants from SDGS Nanded as well. So, may I request some of you to come up here. I also want their certificates here. Or have you already collected them? Okay. So, may I request some of the participants from SDGS Nanded. introduce yourself.
I am Avnay K. Naik and I completed my PhD from SGGS Nanded. The best thing that I felt about this workshop is that we actually got an opportunity to interact with the IIT students. Because many a times it so happens that we do some work individually in other colleges, but what is the thing that IIT students actually do, we are not aware of that. So we actually got an opportunity to see what IIT people actually do and what is the thing that we should be doing so as to be cooperative, or what you can say is to match up to their standards, because IIT is supposed to be one of the biggest, or what you can say, very renowned college in the country. So first of all, I am thankful to Dr. Gadre sir for giving us this opportunity to interact with not only IIT students but also from the institutes which are actually working in the area of wavelets and signal processing. So thank you, sir, and thank you all of you for all your cooperation and for information sharing.
Thank you, Dr. Nair. Have you been given your certificates already? Okay, so you have collected yours. Good. So please arrange to distribute them to the participants. Then I am very happy to also have a participant from, so VNIT Nagpur, I think they may have left because they are trained. VNIT Nagpur, anybody is here? So VNIT Nagpur also represented, as you know, in the morning, but they had a train at 7 o'clock, so they would have definitely left by now. And you know, so, but we'll, and I believe they have collected their certificates already. So now we also have a Professor Patil from, Vani Patil from GHRC. So maybe you can also share your experience, you can come and, GH Rai Sony College.
Thank you, sir. Myself is Vani Patil, an assistant professor in GH Rai Sony College of Engineering. I am very glad to come here and interact with the IIT students. And it is a very amazing experience for me to interact with them. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam. And here's the certificate. Thank you so much for coming. I'm very glad that people from such a distance have come. You know, in fact, we also had a participant from Government College Aurangabad and Government College Jalgaon. We had some participants from Government College Jalgaon. But both, you're here, right? So Aurangabad is here. Good. So, his certificate, have you been able to collect your certificate? No, you've not got it? You've collected, okay. But you can come and share your experience, yeah. Introduce yourself and share.
Hello, I am Jayant Mure. I am from Aurangabad, Government Engineering College, Aurangabad. I am very thankful to Mr. Gadre sir and my institute people for giving me such a good opportunity to attend this workshop. And this workshop is very helpful for the next my work, and I will try to arrange such a workshop at my institute also, because it is a good thing to share the knowledge. So I will try it, sir. Thank you very much for giving me such a.
Very good. I'm very glad that people have come. So in fact, we also had a lot of participation from the Government College Jalgaon. They again had a train very soon in the evening, and I think Jalgaon, are they around or no? They're not here, no. I think they must have left. So we'll place on record our appreciation for their participation as well. I think they've also collected their certificates. I don't know whether our participants from ICT Mumbai are here. I think they may have left also. Oh, they're here. Oh, good, good. I'm glad that you are. So Dr. Anand Kapdi, and in fact, both of them are senior, they're faculty at ICT Mumbai. And they also happen to be faculty from a discipline other than engineering. So we'd definitely like to hear your views. Yeah. ICT Mumbai also is a TechWhip institute.
So it's been always a great opportunity to being here again. I was graduated from here only in 2008. So I never miss an opportunity to be here. So the idea of what actually we interested in is the pedagogy part. Because during MSc or other courses, we never used to have demonstrated something to the people. But here, after coming here in different demonstration, we found that people had been doing something, many things from different papers, different research papers, but many times explaining those to younger people, it remains obscured. So I think this is the first time probably I had been somewhere where people are actually explaining things to the various audiences. So this is very, very important, because whenever during research and another occasions, instances, we have to
visit many different places, different kinds of departments. So we need to have learned the languages so that other people can understand. Because in my domain, if I say something, only that person will be benefited. But it requires the help of other people as well. So in this way, this is very, very important. And I think similar things should carry on. We'll also try ways to do such things in future. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So we appreciate you having come, because you know you've taken time on a Sunday and not in the discipline. So it's very nice of you to spend time, and please convey the same to Dr. Kapoli.
Yeah, sure,
and please,
sure.
This is, you know, these are little mementos from our side. So that leaves me with College of Engineering, Pune. I think they must have, are you around? Or okay. So would you like to share your experience? So we have also have from, so have you collected your certificates? Or okay, but you can share your experience. So I must mention, see, all of us should be aware that under TechWhip, Maharashtra actually is doing rather well, because it has 5 centers of excellence. See, under TechWhip, of course, many institutions are supported by TechWhip, but out of them, only a few institutions also have a center of excellence in an area. So in Maharashtra, SDGS Nanded, College of Engineering Pune, ICT Mumbai, isn't it? ICT Mumbai, VJTI Mumbai, and these are the four institutions which have centers of excellence. And in College of Engineering Pune, there are 2 centers of excellence. Yes, there are 2 centers. That's why there are 5 centers of excellence, probably the maximum in any state, if I'm not, I'll ask. That's quite remarkable. So, you know, many of, and out of them, 3 centers of excellence relate to signal processing and communication. So in Maharashtra, that way, it's a very strong, STGS Nanded is signal processing communication. In fact, VNIT Nagpur also has a center of excellence. So that is, I think, attributed to communication. That's again communication. So 6 that way. So it's quite remarkable. So now I'll request you to.
Myself, Shilpa Paigoda. I am doing PhD in COEP. It was really amazing to learn from even graduate students from IIT. And the approach was very remarkable. It's very difficult to actually learn anything in what is the important property, which direction you should go about. So that that I thought that it was really amazing. Means it's not expected from undergraduate students. And it was a good opportunity to hear from all of you. I should appreciate the enthusiasm that Gadre sir carries, because I have heard him since last maybe 15, 20 years I have been hearing. And he is still that active. So he is a source of inspiration, I think, for all of us. And sir, definitely I'll try to motivate students from COEP to participate in the next year workshops. Thank you, sir.
That's very good to hear. In fact, have you been able to get your certificates, madam? Your group, yeah. Okay. Now, maybe it's a good idea for the centers of excellence to, I'm not saying exactly this kind of activity, but take inspiration from this activity and organize something similar. Might be, you can think about it, how you should do it. But essentially, try and basically have activities where you have a large participation from your student community and faculty community of other TechWhip institutes. You can think about how it should be done. That was one of the reasons of also calling this. Does it make it? So you have 7 institutions. That's very good indeed. College of Engineering Pune, ICT Mumbai, VJTI Mumbai, Government College of Engineering Jalgaon, Government College of Engineering Aurangabad, you know, G.H. Rai Soni College from Nagpur, and VNIT Nagpur. It's remarkable. So it was really remarkable. 7 institutions coming is indeed very good, and we really place on, you know, all of us from IIT place on record our appreciation for these 7 institutes for having come and participated so actively. Now, I would like Professor Chandrasekhar to conclude this session by saying a few words. And before that, just a couple of announcements. Of course, after this, we conclude the workshop. A couple of things that you need to do. All of you are required to submit your evaluation forms. Now, may I request Minal and Himanshu to come forward, please? So, although right now you've been submitting in all kinds of places, but you know, now what we'll do is Minal will collect the forms from the IIT students. So from Minal Tukral will collect the forms from the IIT Bombay students. you submit it to Minal. And from all the other institutes, please submit to Himanshu Soni, right, so as not to create confusion. We will sort out what are already there, but now you please submit out other than IIT forms here, IIT forms there, right. The IIT Bombay students also, you can discuss among yourself. If you are keen to have certificates, we can give them to you. Last year when we asked the participants, they were not very keen to get certificates. But if you are keen to get certificates, even you are entitled to them. If you want them, we can give them to you later, right? We don't have to give them now. But you can discuss it among yourself and convey to your TAs, right? We can do it later. Yeah. So now I'll request, it's important for the IIT Bombay students definitely, and also for the other participants. I suggest that, you should, of course, the IIT Bombay students are anyway doing it. They're submitting a formal, report where they, but for you people also, I think you should, for people from other institutes, try and carry away with you, try and critically write down what you learn from this workshop. That's very important, if you carry away, because you forget it after some time, at least some of the applications that you saw, and that's desirable. In fact, we would be very happy if you sent us some written comments later, right, that's also very welcome. With that then, I will now request Professor Chandrasekhar to conclude the workshop with some of his thoughts and express how he felt everything went.
Good evening once again to all of you. First of all, I must appreciate all of you, because in spite of this busy IPL schedule and then the BPL, La Liga and the NBA schedules, all of you have come and shown utmost interest in taking this part of your course, that Wavelets course, very seriously, and then really kudos to all of you. I have interacted with some of the students. Of course, I could not meet all because, all groups are actively and then very interestingly discussing with others. So whosoever group was free, so I could just sneak in and then discuss with them. What I found, this is my observation, what I found in all these things were the constructive criticism that the groups have got from their peers. Peers means whosoever visit and then discuss, I see a lot of active discussion going on. It's like, grilling, how did you do this? So, tell me this. Well, what happens if you don't do this? So, of course, all of you are students, see, why I'm telling this is at student level, we'll discuss later. This type of attitude was not there. So, that's a great seriousness I have seen in all these presentations, wherever I have seen. I hope this was the case in all other presentations also. So, this is a very good sign, getting a constructive criticism from your own classmates. Okay, that is very good. It was not a leg pulling. I don't say it leg pulling, but maybe in a positive sense it is a leg pulling. But this is required. This is required for development of research. And this is what I am very happy to see here. Like I have said in the last year, I have learnt a lot also in the last year because of some of these new presentations. But I could see some of the present presentations are repetitive of those things. For example, the iris scanning, or even the stock market prediction of series and all these type of things are easy, but I definitely am sure that there is the present presentations are slightly different from the previous ones. I could sense that. Okay, and of course I am sure that means each and every problem, whether it is image processing or is any other mostly image and then denoising or whatever, there has been some improvement from the previous year to now. And definitely it will be from now to next year. This is what a very positive sign that I have seen in all your presentations, and this is really appreciable. Okay, I don't belong to earth science, I don't belong to electrical engineering. I basically come from earth science faculty in IIT, and I am very much interested to see in that context, some of our friends have presented wavelet analysis of seismic signals. Okay, that was very interesting. and then we could have some good healthy discussion. And as I had told also, solution of differential equations or partial differential equations using wavelets, this is another new topic which I am very much interested in. So I could see all those, you know, topics in all these topics in this presentations, and I'm really happy. I think my Sunday is completely, you know, justified by being here. So I thank Professor Gadre once again for this. So I take this opportunity to thank you all once again for making me learn something, some new things today. And I'm going with a full heart, going home with a full heart, and then thinking that how I can extend this to my earth science related problems. One problem which I just want to make it here is the new problem, you know, new topics which are coming is nowadays I'm working on fractal analysis. The topic which we want to, you know, project or take it or develop rather is wavelet based fractal analysis. Okay, fractal analysis has its own advantages which we have applied to geophysical borehole data. That means for oil companies, where whenever they drill boreholes, they will have different geophysical data sets. So for those things we have applied fractal analysis. So how this fractal analysis can be combined with wavelets? So in our recent book, myself and Professor Gadre along with another author, we have written a book on wavelets and fractals in earth system sciences. In that we have also given a part of a chapter as wavelet based fractal methods. That procedure was different, and the procedure that we are currently, myself and my student, we are currently working on is different. So I would like to see such type of newness in new data processing techniques. In the forthcoming tech workshops, and definitely I am sure I will not be disappointed. Thank you very much. Thank you, Professor Gadre, once again.
Thank you very much, Professor Chandrasekhar. That was a very important set of ideas which you placed before us. And now, of course, I think it's a long day, and however, a day that we thought was spent in a very worthwhile manner. I hope you all carry away with you a lot that you've learned from here. And for the IIT Bombay students, of course, this is all a part of your syllabus, so it can be examined in your final exam, right? So do enjoy yourself on what you've learned and carry this with you all your life. And the same thing holds for all the students and faculty of other institutions. Carry what you've learned from you, not only in terms of the bare knowledge of wavelets, time frequency methods or multirate systems, but also the pedagogy which you learn from here and the pedagogical approaches that we talked about. Again, I hope that in some way it also finds a part in your syllabus, it forms a part of your syllabus in some way, or at least forms a part of your investigations in research, development and study. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best.